I noticed that when my cats were really hungry and wanted me to feed them, they tended to have a rising melody. They would go meow. But when they were sitting in their cat carriers on the way to the vets, they would go in a very more sad sort of falling pitch. Meow. And that's what started it all, I think. I'm Suzanne Schutz, and I'm an Associate Professor of Phonetics at Lund University and the Humanities Lab. The name of my project is Melody in Human-Cat Communication, MEOWSIC, and the aim of the project is to learn more about the melody in the communication between humans and cats. How important is the melody when we communicate across species? I have six cats of my own now, and I've, being a linguist, a phonetician, you can't help noticing the huge variation in their voices when they're communicating with humans. And cats have a very large vocal repertoire as well. They don't just meow, they can purr and hiss and growl and howl. But I think that many humans want to understand their cats, and they make an effort to do so. We visit cats and their owners with our equipment, which is a video camera that we stand at a certain distance to observe the whole context, the whole scenery. And we place video cameras on the forehead of the owners so we can film their perspective when they're looking at the cats and so on. And the cats, they get small wireless microphones which are attachable to their collars. So they can actually walk around in the room without any wires and stuff. So, and we can record their vocalizations with a very good audio quality. We take home the data and we annotate it. We try to figure out which vocalization type every vocalization of the cat is, and we also annotate the human speech. In positive contexts, like in feeding time, when the cat wants to be let inside or outside the house, for instance, and also in positive mental states, when the cats are content, when they are attention-seeking, the melody tends to rise. While in negative context and in negative mental states, when the cats are stressed, anxious, discontent, the melody tends to decline. Oh, I've used the competence, and I've also been able to borrow equipment in order to decide which equipment was the best to film cats, because cats are notoriously hard to videotape. Large number of colleagues who are willing to sit down and talk and discuss your research problems with you. It has been really, really rewarding for this project, I think. It's Joost van der Weijer, who is also at Lund University and also works in the Humanities Lab. And it's Robert Eklund, who is at Linköping University. And it's me. And we are a small research group, but we have consultants in other disciplines as well, in veterinary medicine, in ethology, behavioral sciences, in biology and so on. So we feel that we have a support from other disciplines as well. It is important that we learn more about how humans interact with other species, and it has potential applications also in other disciplines. Humans tend to use different speech styles when they address cats. It's similar to the way that we talk to small children or infants. I've also found a huge interest among the general public. They want to learn more about how to communicate better with their cats.